Welcome to the Eye of Truth. One day in 1950 at Los Alamos National Laboratory, a group of top theoretical physicists met for lunch. All of them were core members of the Manhattan Project. The conversation shifted towards aliens, and a physicist named Enrico Fermi asked everyone the following question: where are the extraterrestrials? It's a good question, and one that we've all thought about at one time or another. However, the fact that Enrico Fermi would even ask this question is exceedingly strange. Fermi was awarded the 1938 Nobel Prize in Physics and played an extremely important role in the Manhattan Project. Along with J. Robert Oppenheimer, he is considered one of the architects of the atomic age. Fermi had one particularly impressive talent. He could quickly estimate a mostly accurate answer to questions that would normally be very difficult to investigate. For example, how many ants are there on the Earth? How many piano tuners are there in the USA? Fermi had figured out some way of answering these kinds of difficult questions. In fact, it was when using his usual method to estimate the number of alien civilizations in the universe that he arrived at a startling contradiction. This contradiction, where are the extraterrestrials, is now known as the Fermi paradox. Why is this question a paradox? What is the contradiction behind this paradox? Why are we unable to find aliens? In this video, I'll answer these questions as I take multiple approaches in considering whether aliens might actually exist. Be sure to stay with me until the end. A paradox refers to something that exhibits contradictory aspects. How then is where are the extraterrestrials a paradox? Fermi estimated the number of alien civilizations based on the number of Earth-like planets in space. He calculated that there should be 100 trillion civilizations throughout the observable universe. That's a lot. If we consider just our own Milky Way galaxy, there should be around 1,000 civilizations. Fermi's estimation was verified by an American astrophysicist named Frank Drake, using a stricter methodology called the Drake equation. Surprisingly, he found that there should be even more than 100 trillion intelligent civilizations throughout the universe. If this is true, and there are so many civilizations throughout the universe, then why haven't we been able to find any trace of their existence? In a previous video, I discussed the Kardashev scale and mentioned that our civilization would become a Type 1 planetary civilization if we continue to advance for another 200 years. If we then continue to advance 3,000 years or more, we could become a Type 2 stellar civilization. After 100,000 or 1 million years of development, humanity could become a Type 3 galactic civilization. According to Kardashev anyway, a Type 3 civilization should leave traces of itself throughout the galaxy. For example, a physicist named Freeman Dyson came up with the concept of a Dyson sphere, which could obtain nearly all the energy released by a star. I mentioned this in a previous video. Another interesting concept comes from a mathematician named John von Neumann, who posited the existence of advanced artificial objects called self-replicating spacecraft. A self-replicating spacecraft would be similar to an organism in that it could reproduce and create other machines. Von Neumann believed that an advanced civilization would send self-replicating spacecraft to other planets to search for resources or other intelligent life. Once a spacecraft arrived on a planet, it would immediately replicate itself and send the second craft to a different planet. Therefore, if an advanced civilization had launched even a single self-replicating spacecraft millions of years ago, we'd now be able to see these spacecrafts nearly everywhere throughout the civilization's home galaxy. However, we've been unable to confirm the existence of even a single one of these spacecrafts in the Milky Way. Of course, Dyson spheres and self-replicating spacecraft are just examples of possible technologies that an advanced civilization could create. These examples are presented by scientists simply to show that we should be able to observe evidence of an alien civilization existing. I mentioned that it could take 1 million years for us to become a Type 3 civilization. Although this seems like a very long time, a million years is just a moment in time on a cosmological scale. Earth formed 4.6 billion years ago, and our universe is 13.8 billion years old. If there's some planet out there that's just slightly older than Earth, with a civilization just 1 million years older than ours, they could already be a Type 3 civilization. If that's true, then our universe should be crawling with machines created by such an advanced civilization. However, we have yet to find even a single trace of an alien civilization. This contradiction, where are the extraterrestrials, is the Fermi paradox. There are many explanations for this paradox that attempt to answer why we've been unable to discover any alien civilizations. These explanations can be broadly classified into one of three categories. Let's go over each of these in detail. According to the rare earth hypothesis, Earth is the only planet in the universe hosting an advanced civilization. Although other planets could contain simple forms of life such as microbes or bacteria, no planet other than Earth hosts advanced forms of life like humans. The reason for this is that it's nearly impossible for a planet to satisfy all the requirements necessary for advanced forms of life to develop. The atmosphere covering Earth's surface, the magnetic field generated by Earth itself, its distance from the Sun, and its distance from other planets are just some of the countless conditions required for life. Earth is the only planet that satisfies them all. In other words, we are the first advanced civilization in the universe. According to the greatfilter hypothesis, life must overcome several major barriers as it continues to evolve. However, a civilization will ultimately encounter a barrier it simply cannot overcome. This barrier can even cause the destruction of the civilization. One of these barriers might be the creation of life. Life is created and continues to exist thanks to a complicated combination of various chemical substances and miraculous functions. However, no matter what we do, we are unable to create even the most simplest forms of life in our laboratories. It is therefore very difficult for life to form. This is the first barrier that must be crossed as a civilization develops. The second barrier is whether a simple form of life can evolve into something more advanced. It took around 1 billion years for life on Earth to evolve from simple to complicated forms, showing how high this barrier is. In other words, the fact that our civilization has reached our current level means that we've already overcome several major barriers. In the future, we may encounter other barriers. No one knows what these might be. However, one possibility might be war. The human race could ultimately be wiped out by global nuclear war. Or, if we aren't able to colonize space before we use up all of the resources on Earth, our population will gradually decrease due to lack of energy, and our civilization could be destroyed. This would be another barrier. One possibility is that any civilizations that might have existed in the universe encountered some impossible barrier and were destroyed before they could develop technology to colonize space. This is why we've been unable to discover even a single alien civilization, according to the greatfilter hypothesis. If this hypothesis is true, the fact that we've been unable to discover extraterrestrial life is actually a good thing for human civilization. Why? If extraterrestrial life doesn't exist, that means that we've already overcome some extremely difficult barriers, and having been able to overcome these barriers puts us in a very unique position within the universe. In contrast, if we do discover extraterrestrial life, that means that the barriers we've overcome weren't really that difficult at all. In other words, civilizations with human-like intelligence wouldn't be so rare throughout the universe, and this would mean that we're much more likely to be approaching a barrier we might really have trouble overcoming. The possibility that alien life may be too alien seems most likely to me. Humanity has been seeking extraterrestrial life only for the last 100 years or so. Our efforts over the last several decades have focused mainly on detecting electromagnetic waves emitted by alien civilizations. However, alien civilizations may not use electromagnetic waves like we do. It's also possible that we wouldn't be able to understand what we're seeing, even if an alien civilization was thriving right in front of our eyes. For example, the human body is host to countless bacteria. Even if these bacteria had some level of intelligence, they probably would be completely unaware of the existence of the humans that contain them. What's more, as I've often mentioned in previous videos, living things might not necessarily have physical bodies and could take the form of beings of pure consciousness. We would be completely unable to detect such beings, even if they were standing right in front of us. That covers the three major explanations for the Fermi paradox. But I'd like to mention one other explanation that I find very interesting. This explanation is the dark forest theory, suggested in the science fiction novel, The Three-Body Problem. According to this theory, there are many civilizations throughout the universe, all of which are attempting to secure their share of limited resources and prioritize their own development. The biggest obstacle in the way of achieving these priorities is the existence of other civilizations. So, our universe is like a giant black forest. Each civilization is like a hunter carrying a rifle, who hides himself in the woods and is always on guard. Imagine that we meet another one of these hunter civilizations. Differences in civilization, race, and communications would make it very difficult to understand each other. In other words, it would be very difficult to determine whether the other civilization is friendly or hostile. Even if the other civilization claims to be friendly, it would be difficult to know whether this is true. Conversely, even if we attempt to show that we are friendly, the other civilization couldn't know for sure. We would see each other as possible dangers. We would be unable to understand one another and would continue to suspect each other. A simple misunderstanding on your part could result in the destruction of your own civilization. Therefore, the best course of action to take if we discover a different civilization would be to attack first and destroy it, in order to eliminate the threat. Most advanced civilizations throughout the universe would understand this, and would do whatever they could to remain hidden. A civilization such as ours that makes no attempt to hide would ultimately be attacked by another civilization. If this theory is correct, it could explain why we haven't been able to find any Dyson spheres or self-replicating spacecraft. That's a pretty depressing theory, but it could be worse. For example, the Earth prison theory I discussed in a previous video could also explain the Fermi paradox. There's another hypothesis similar to the dark forest theory. It states that there's a single super civilization in the universe that monitors the universe for activity and destroys any civilization that develops into a threat. There are many possible explanations as to why we haven't been able to find any aliens, and none of them are perfect. However, even though we don't have any solid evidence yet, I do think that one of these explanations contains the truth. It's possible that humans will never know the truth behind the Fermi paradox. This seems frustrating, but it all depends on what the truth really is. We might be better off if we never find out.